Calling this meeting to order at 7:06. I know that's cut into our 15 minutes, but we'll do it. So we need to review and approve the minutes from March 8th and the budget subcommittee meeting minutes on March 8th. So let's do the meeting minutes first.
Madam Chairman?
Yes, sir.
I discussed with Mr. Haller the fact that we should make a correction on the motion of Philip Cantor, and was seconded by Bill Smith, taking and reducing the FY17 budget, and but also part of the same motion was to take from the E&D account the money to be used in FY16.
So instead of it being two separate motions,
you can do it any way you want, but
it could be the same motion, but it, like he's saying, agreed to reduce the which is not their FY217 budget, and then after 255-490 as follows, put a number one there, transfer from E&D for funds in FY16 expenditures.
All right, go over that again. Everybody get that? Do it again.
So after it said Bill Smith second, it will agree to reduce the FY2017 budget of 255-490 as follows. And he put a number one there, but we could do it, but he could, from the number one where it goes there, transfer E&D the funds to fund, E&D funds to fund the F16 expenditures, which are the 185-490, the 50,000, and Marty's retirement.
So those are being funded by it. Okay.
By the E&D
this year, deficiency.
To reduce the two, just.
Yeah. Okay. Do you have it there?
Yeah, I have it right here.
Is everybody good with that?
Yes.
Okay.
I'll get together with Don and we'll make the correct.
All right. Okay.
What was corrected?
Do you have a second?
Second.
All those in favor of accepting the minutes from March 8th? Opposed? Any abstentions? Okay. So now we need to approve the budget subcommittee meeting minutes of March 8th.
So moved.
Thank you. Do I have a second? Keith? Any discussion on that? Hearing none, all those in favor? Opposed? Okay, it's unanimous. Thank you. Okay, Patty?
Okay, so tonight I gave you the March report. To review, Mr. Decker came in and reviewed some invoices with me this week. Pleasure to have in the office. You have 23 warrants presented to you tonight for $1,266,986.70. I thank you for signing those. I also gave you the tentatively approved budget. This is the finalized copy for you. I'm hoping there are no errors in it. I tried to double, triple, quadruple check. Going back to this year's budget, now that the meeting minutes are approved, the next meeting you will see those monies added to the budget, and I will also file a Schedule 19 amendment with the Department of Elementary and Secondary Education as is required.
Now, my next question.
Go ahead.
You didn't have a point.
Anyway, my point is, how are things shaking out through June 30th? And are we going to be in any deficits that we don't already know about? And can we cover those deficits with other money?
No. The areas that I've been most concerned about since the beginning of the year have been the tuitions. But I think that we're going to have enough savings in our salaries, our heat, and they're plowing to cover those. So right now, I'm not concerned, even though we are showing some deficit spending in some line items. I'm not, at this point, I am not concerned.
Do we need to put a freeze on any of those accounts that are already in a deficit?
We can. They have to continue to spend their tuition accounts. The children are still attending.
Those we're stuck with.
Right.
But are there anything else discretionary?
No. I don't feel we need 30.
One thing, when I did go down and go see stuff with Patty yesterday, I was a little bit alarmed that the school revolving account, they spent $3,000 to make four trips with the ski team to Berkshire East. And I think that's pretty extravagant. I don't know how we save that money, but, you know, there were two of them were $700 and two of them were $800.
I do want to make one clarification that I found out. Mr. Modesto and I and Mr. Dredge and I had been having conversations with Mr. Sanderson, our athletic director, but that isn't just the ski team, it's also the ski club. So it's a combined ski team, ski club, and there's probably three times the number of kids in the club that there are at the team.
Club is close to 60 in it, yeah, and about 50 going each trip.
We are looking at the fees for those clubs and possibly raising the athletic fee for the ski team. And there is, what was the other sport we were looking, wasn't there one other sport we were looking at too because of the cost? Maybe golf? Is it golf? No?
No, I mean, no, we were just looking at that. I mean, club is being one thing, raising club and team are two different things.
Right. We're looking into raising the fees for the ski club and the ski team so that the fees pay for those. Part of the problem is that we cannot use a school bus because there's nowhere to stow the equipment. So you have to rent a King Ward coach bus because they have the underneath storage. Mr. Decker also brought up the point, couldn't someone just bring up the skis in a pickup truck? Well, you could, but then you own the liability if anything should happen to anyone's equipment. And we don't want to take that liability. We'd rather pass that on to King Coach Ward or King Ward, whatever his name is.
So is this $700 a trip and then
yes,
back and forth with gas and everything else? That's really not bad. That's really not bad
but
for
he is,
Coach
he
Bus.
Is correct about, you know, we do need to look at it. The model was that the ski, because we were paying for the ski team to go up anyways, you add it on the ski club, it was kind of, it kind of got, it gets vague to what's, who's paying for what portion of that bus trip. Mm-hmm. And so, and over the years, that's how it was, and we never looked at, you know, we said, you know, we didn't want to create a, we didn't want to price out the activity because there's very few winter activities.
Right.
So that was the mentality on that. So, you know, how we, you know, how we can make that more closer to go in the black instead of in the red, we're going to meet to discuss. So
in the past, we would have like 20 kids on the ski team and six kids in the club that would tag along. Now it's the opposite. We got six kids on the team and 20 tag-alongs in the club.
And
so
we have
to flip them.
Is the sports fee the same for everyone?
Yeah.
So are you going to add a surcharge, or are you just going to raise
everyone?
So we're
going to charge a surcharge for the ski club.
So is that going
to
kill the ski club?
And so they already paid it. They have to pay their own lift tickets when they get there. So
right. It's expensive.
It starts getting very expensive. But we have to look at it and see what it is. And we decide what we take from athletics and activities to cost, you know, to cover some of those costs, and how much should we do that for a school club.
So, 3 minutes.
Thank you. And I would just like to speak out in favor of ski team and ski club spending. I know of several families that is the reason they school choice into this district.
Because
alpine skiing, neighboring, Greenfield doesn't have it. And a lot of the neighboring schools don't have it. So that's a big deal. And
but we're not saying we don't want to have it. We're just saying the fees have to be more reasonable to the cost of the sport.
Okay, that said, what is a cost to the golf team? How many people do you have on the golf team?
Well, it's
I don't think it was. It might not have been the golf team.
No. It's just a question. How many people do you have on the golf team?
They play, was it 10? They have six.
Six
and then
people.
Six score, 10.
Six scores.
Two alternates.
And then the alternates.
Okay, and then, so they go places in a school bus or in the van?
The van.
Okay, and they pay the same amount that everyone else pays? So, do you see where I'm going with this? I mean, that should be covering something, or are you going to lower the cost for them because it doesn't cost as much to bring them places even though they're paying the same amount? So you're going to surcharge somebody because it's costing a lot, but you're not taking away anything from another team that's not costing nearly as much as anyone else.
The only thing that we would separate there is one's a club and one's a sport. So if you were on the alpine ski team, you would pay the athletic user fee that's consistent for all sports.
So you would not have a surcharge.
Right.
You would have
other schools do charge more for other sports. So when our kids play hockey in the co-op up the street in Turner's, they actually have to pay $235 to play up there because hockey has a surcharge. And so we looked at other neighboring districts about what they're doing. We're kind of, we're in the middle. There are some districts that have no fees for athletics, and there's a, it's a conscious decision because of the economics of the city or town. And there are others, you go down the Long Meadow, you pay $300 to play basketball. And I'm making up that number, but it's a much higher number than we're paying. So overall, per sport, they're paying a lot more. So, I mean, each school committee is looking at what they want to do for their town so they don't, you know, price out people and that kind of thing. So when we're talking about skiing, we're talking about the club itself, you know, really, and where Bob is coming from, I think, is he's saying, really, it should be self-sufficient. It shouldn't take school funds. We have kind of crossed that line because, well, ski team members are on the bus. So we're paying for the bus anyways. So let's reduce some of the costs that go to the club members because we want to keep that price down. And so we got to make sure now that the price of this coach buses have gone up over the years. I think it's one of those things that's kind of crept along. We have to see now, should ski club pay $125 for the season instead of $100 for the season? And then it gets more complicated.
No, I agree.
It also
gets
more complicated than that because we also do the reduction if you play more than one sport.
Right.
And skiing is your second sport. You're now down to $85.
The thing about the ski, though, is that the equipment, the kit that they need to go racing is ridiculous. There's no other sport that comes close to
hockey.
No, not two pair of skis, the racing out, the whole racing suit, the whatever. That. The kit for your kid to ski race is $3,000 to $4,000.
You provide a bib.
And may I just say something? Because I think there was a very important thing said, that these guys are figuring that out. And they are looking at the minutiae of what's happening. I just would like to say that I think our job is this and this, the overall budget. And we have our expert here who's combing through this, right? I mean, and I think it's most important that the report we get is, where are we?
Correct. You know? Our job is also to ask questions so that we can adjust the budget accordingly. And that's where we're at now. So the fact that it's the club we're talking about raising a fee on, I don't have a problem with that. But I do have a problem if it's an unbalanced thing across.
Right.
So we can move along, Bob. You want to say one more word?
My point bringing the whole thing up is we spent E&D money a year or so ago to buy that nice white bus to take so many children, okay?
And but you understand the equipment thing.
Yeah, I do. But I also understand that most of these people who have these skis, they have cases for the, to the skis, and they're in a case. So, and we bought a pickup truck. I don't know if the skis are too long, so go in the back of it and put a cap on it.
Understand, to save money, the ski team takes the school van, they put their skis in the back of Brian Delaney's car truck, and they drive it up there. So on the off day, ski team skis every day of the week, or almost every day of the week. And so they take the school van to save money, and they put the skis in a truck like you're saying. Except when you add 50 kids, and 50 sets of keys.
So
that's when they do the. That's where I'm saying that's where
the club went with them.
That's because, and then the club's with them, and so that's where we say it gets foggy because where we save money one day of the week, we're spending a little bit more another day of the week with the rest of the other kids.
Okay.
And that's where I say it's kind of, you know, you're right, it could be looked at.
My thinking was if you bought a cap for the back of the pickup truck that we own, right? I don't know if we have one. Would it hold the ski that somebody drives the pickup, somebody drives the bus? But I don't know whether it's bigger.
But the white bus is not big enough for 50 club players and probably six.
Well, again, 50, yeah.
Okay, so I think we've beat that subject enough. So let's move it along. Thank you very much. Please keep us informed.
I will.
And public comment. Our public has left.
Oh, thank you.
Student Advisory Council is not available tonight. Wisely. So we'll be moving on. We have no unfinished business, so new business, school choice recommendations.
So if you look at the sheet in the handout, you'll see the school choice recommendations. I guess the is the exact same proposal I've asked of last year.
Mm-hmm.
In the high school, you know, we take what we can get. We'll get more in ninth grade than usual. That number will go up by a few more. Usually ninth grade transfers. If people aren't interested this early in the year. They'll start looking in May, June. So we usually get about a half a dozen or so in ninth grade. It's a seventh and eighth grade where I have, you know, the greater than sign, greater or, you know, greater or less than sign rather than five, because we got to keep, right now we have a little bump in the numbers coming up from the elementaries, and you can look down and you can see that, and I have to keep that number between 115 and 120, or else the class sizes start to get above 24 within our scheduling. So, and we don't, that's kind of where the number I'm looking at. So, you know, if I can, I try to take as much as I can to get this, you know, to max out that number as much as possible. So I'm looking, I'm asking for being able to do up to five. If for some reason, again, if you look at that grade seven, the total number of students we expect is 133. We average between 128 and 135, I would guess, over the last 5 years, is that number coming in. So we do lose that amount, and we usually end up getting around 115. So that's kind of what I wrote at the bottom. We lose 15 to 20 students. And that's for the full boat. Those are all going different directions. You know, we can kind of go through and see what that looks like. And that's what we've been, as you guys have heard, I've been trying to push to make sure what those big people making decisions are thinking things through. And then you can see again where the 121, it's actually a little bit larger class. We lose about 10 to 15 students to tech, and then about five students to private. Usually DA takes two or three, and then, you know, one or two to Williston or, you know, some of the other private schools they do for high school. So there's not a whole lot of, we don't lose a whole lot of choice going out, you know, after we have them in. So okay. Those are, so that's what that looks like. So anyway, so that's what the numbers look like, and so that's what I'm looking for.
So could I have a motion to leave school choice recommendations to the discretion of the principal? Do I have a second?
You have a second.
Not to exceed.
All those in favor. All those in favor. You are
no. It's already too late.
All right. Yeah.
All those
in
favor.
36
Opposed. Thank you very much. I trust him.
I have a question. For
you have a question. Go ahead.
On the enrollment stuff we got the other day, it appears that our enrollment has gone up substantially since October 1st. We're up, my math is kind of crude, but we're up, 100, we're up 23 kids, my math right? And, but some of them appear to be SP.
I think, can I explain? I think at the beginning of the year, we were not counting our out-of-district kids, and now we are.
Let's see where it says one. 636.
Yes, so you're correct. The
it's the way we're counting.
It's right. The way we're counting them. We are up. We have gone up. We've accepted more students. More students have moved in. And, you know, sometimes you win and lose on that. And I think we probably, let me say, Scott, probably about 6 to 10 probably new students.
Yeah, they transitioned this year. At the semester, at the start of the second semester, we got a few new students.
Okay. But were it's they not choice kids, or were they
moved in?
Just moved, we don't take school choice mid-year. We do it the semester, but not.
So the October one, you should have some sort of a asterisk on it to reflect the fact that it's not active.
Bob, can you make a note of that? So we can bring it to Mary.
That the October 1st has an asterisk so that we can have an explanation of it on the paper for the numbers.
I'll get that done. My secretary creates that, so I'll get that done.
Okay. Thank you. Anyone
you
else?
Send it to me, I read.
Okay, we have no executive session, so a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second?
Right here.
At 7:25?
We don't want to thank you.